I am Jasmine Masters, and I have something to say. This is something that happened to me a while ago. And this is just how my mind and how naive I am about things. I was in a club, at a club one time in Palm Springs, and I was sitting there talking to some guys, and, you know, we just having a good conversation. And they was like, girl, do you do Tina? I was like, yeah, I do Tina. I do Tina all the time. As a matter of fact, I'm about to do Tina tonight. Well, they was like, okay, well, girl, we finna go around the corner and do some Tina real quick. And I'm thinking to myself, why the hell y'all going around the corner and do Tina? Which one of y'all about to get up and drag and do Tina? Like, what club? Well, once I realized what they was talking about, and the guy was like, no, we finna go do Tina. And I was like, oh, no, boo. I'm Tina Turner. I do Tina Turner, the singer. I do Tina Turner. I don't do Tina. I never knew what Tina was until I was in, you know, Palm Springs, and the boys brought it up. And this was like maybe, years ago. I don't know how many years ago. Then one other time, I was in a club called Peanuts, which is a real known training type bar where celebrities go pick up the girls. It was there before, but it's not there anymore. But it's there, but it's not the penis, what I'm talking about. Well, I was at the bar drinking me a glass of red wine, and this guy walked up to me, and we talking and stuff, and he was like, are you functional? And me being me, I'm like, hell yeah, I'm functional. Like, what the hell do you mean am I functional? Like, and I'm here having a conversation with you. Mind you, we've been talking for like 15 minutes, just a conversation. So I'm like, yes, I'm functional. But the host at the time, which is Viva, she was on the side, but she heard the conversation. She already knew, like, you know, I wasn't into me trying to hook up with guys in drag or trying to fool anybody or anything like that. So she was like, oh, no. You're like, sir, this girl is not that girl. She's just a showgirl. So when she told me what functional was, I gagged because he was asking me, did my dick get up? Meaning, was I on hormones? You know, sometimes the girls, like the transsexual girls, they take hormones and they dick don't get up. So they be limp dick all the time. And he was trying to figure out, was he dealing with the limp dick bitch, or was he talking to a bitch that dick got up? And I was like, I'm very functional. So he got excited and got it. But when I realized what he was talking about, you know, I was like, oh no, you know, thank you very kindly. But no, I'm very performance stage teeth, and I get off, get out of that. And I'm in my fade and I'm cool. So that was just a couple of things that I wanted to share with you guys, because I always tell my friends that story, and they was like, girl, share it, so I'm sharing it. But before I get off here, oh, he is cute, but he got a skateboard, so he must live at home with his mama. All right. But before I get off here, somebody asked me, how do I deal with a lot of bullshit, a lot of drama, and how do I be so positive and not know, or when people say bad things about me? One thing I do and one thing I have done is when I wake up in the morning, I am so blessed that I woke up, first of all. I always take a deep breath and say, I am who I am. I love myself. I love my flaws. If somebody gonna like it, somebody gonna love it. I have to deal with this. Everything God gave me, I deal with. So what I wanna say is, if everyone take a deep breath and just say, I am who I am, I love who I am, I respect who I am, and I accept who I am. If you do that, and if you write down, I'm just going to say three things that you want to do for yourself to achieve whatever the goal may be, whatever you wanted to do for yourself while you're still alive on earth today, you won't give a fuck about what the next bitch, bastard, whore, slut, tramp say about you. You know why? Because your mind is focused on what you need to do to make yourself happy. I need for everyone to take a moment to accept who they are. If you focus on yourself, you won't have time for the other bullshit. You won't gossip about what this bitch is doing, because you have a goal to set for yourself. Just set a goal for yourself and do it. That'll save a whole bunch of bullshit and a whole bunch of drama. Everybody who's alive today have a goal or something that you wanted to do for yourself in your life. Do it. all that negative energy that you put out there or that you may receive, put all that towards something you want to do, whether it's going to school for something, whether it's doing a pageant, whether it's getting on RuPaul's Drag Race, whether it's being with a man you want to be, whatever the case may be, do it now. And all that drama shit, let that shit go. If you're sitting there reading the girls and spending all your time reading the girls, you're wasting your life by spending your time reading me or me reading everybody else. Focus on your own fucking ass and then get your life together. Don't worry about what the next bitch is doing. If she's sucking dick for free and she hungry, that's her business. If he over there getting fucked and he ain't got no food, that's his business. Whatever the case may be, if you focus on your ass, thine ass, your ass, and sprawl all your own shit that you need to fix out, you won't worry about nobody else's shit. I am Jasmine Masters. Please follow me on Twitter, Jasmine Masters, on Instagram, MS Jasmine Masters, on Facebook, which I have a fan page. I can't accept any more friends on Facebook, but on my fan page, I'm on there. People always say, well, girl, you don't be on the bitch. I am on there. I won't tell you to go if I'm not. So please like my fan page. Follow me on Twitter. Everything is Jasmine Masters. My Instagram is MS Masters, Jasmine Masters, okay? Let's get it together. 2015 is coming, and we need a change. Nyesha Dupree said, if everyone just say something positive to each other, just give out a positive note, that'd be good. And I agree with her 100%. That is a legend in this drag community, and sometimes we need the legends to step up. So I'm going to say this. Other than giving someone just a goodbye and a hello and how you doing and, you know, whatever, all the legends out there, because I know all of you out there from all over the world have some type of drag that you could give to a newcomer that is starting up. Donate something to a new girl, whether it's a dress, gown, earring, ring, bracelet, shoes, whatever. Anything you don't use, donate it to a girl who may could use it. That is the way we can start making a change in our own community. Like Nyesha said, please say something positive. Let's bring it back to what it's supposed to be. We all about giving, caring, and loving each other. Now, donate something to a girl who's trying to start out. Let's help the girls who are trying to start what we already established and the ones before me that established. Let's keep it going to where we can have our own network in our own life, because we don't have a lot of shit anyway as it is, because we're still fighting to get fucking marriage and all that other shit. So let's get it together, folks. Straight folks, you too. Quit thinking that gay is some type of fucking sin, because it's fucking not. We are born a human. We all bleed and we all fucking pee. Now I'm out of here because I gotta go get my coin daughter because the night is over. Well, the day is over. Oh yeah, she got her coin. She happy. Bye y'all. Love you. Oh yeah, she got them coin daughters. Let me go. All right, remember, all you legends out there in Atlanta, all y'all, donate something to a girl who's trying to get into the business. Take a little bit of time to help the next drag queen out, because you never know who's going to host the next show. Now, I'm Jasmine Masters, and I have spoken, and I approve this message.